History Arts in Bangalore, and today we're going to be making a very famous Mexican dessert called Tres Leches, which translates to three milks, right? So this dessert is originates from Mexico, and the company Nestle sort of branded it and made it a little popular when they started using evaporated milk, condensed milk that is made by this company. And that's how this dessert became really popular. So a little more about the dessert. A tres leches sponge, okay? So what it is essentially is a cake that is soaked with three kinds of milk. That's why the name tres leches. So the sponge is a nice aerated and fluffy sponge, but not too moist, okay? Because it needs to, once it's baked, it then gets soaked with three kinds of milk, which classically is condensed milk, evaporated milk, and whole milk or heavy cream. So the option again is to use whole milk or heavy cream. I'll be using whole milk today. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a mango tres leches, which is because we're doing mango week. So we thought we'd adapt this recipe. Also, I'm going to be doing an eggless version of this recipe. So traditionally, this is a non-egg, it's an egg-based dessert, okay? So the variation that I'm going to show you is an eggless sponge. So I hope most of our viewers are happy that we're doing an eggless recipe today. So in the sponge, again, we won't get the exact same texture like I would get with eggs, because when I use eggs, I would be getting a lot of aeration in my sponge, whereas here I'm going to be relying mainly on chemical leaveners like baking soda, baking powder to get that rise. So while it's not exactly the same texture, it's good enough, you'll still enjoy. I've also given it a slight twist by adding some mango pulp to the ingredients. So your sponge will be a light yellow color, plus we're adding a little cinnamon powder. So that gives it again that nice taste on the palate. Okay, for soaking, if you've seen the ingredients, I'm going to be using condensed milk, I'm going to be using coconut milk and whole milk. So again, this combination is going to give it a nice flavor combination along with the mango that I'm going to be using. Okay, and to finish the dessert, we'll finish with some whipping cream and some fresh mangoes. Alright, so I think we'll quickly go ahead and look at the ingredients that we have today. You've already seen the ingredients that are posted on the story on the Academy page. So these are all the wet ingredients that we're going to be using. There's 40 grams of curd. So what I've done today is that I've divided the recipe by three, because I wanted to just do a smaller batch as I've already prepared. So the recipe that's mentioned to you, I've divided this amount by three, which is why you see smaller quantities over here. All right, quickly, curd, 40 grams. Milk with a little vanilla essence, 20 grams. Mango pulp. This mango pulp has been reduced. So you would take about 50 grams and reduce it down to 20. You could use fresh mangoes and just remove some of the water till you get a thick pulp like this. I also have some fresh cream, which is 40 grams. Okay. I have the dry ingredients over here. Cinnamon powder, 1.5 grams. Flour, 140 grams. Baking soda, 3 grams. Baking powder, 3 grams. And at last, melted butter that will go into the batter. That's 60 grams. Okay, over here I have the ingredients for the soaking sauce, like it's mentioned, for soaking. So there is 100 grams of milk, 100 grams of coconut milk, and 100 grams of condensed milk. We'll come to the soaking later. For now, we're going to start with the sponge, okay? So, to begin with the sponge, what we require are two bowls, okay? One is for the wet ingredients and the other bowl is for the dry ingredients. So I'm going to combine all the wet ingredients into one bowl. I'm going to sieve all my dry ingredients into another bowl, and then I'm going to combine these two, and at last I will mix with the melted butter. Okay, so starting with the wet ingredients, curd, milk, the mango pulp, cream. You could, I've used a dairy-based cream because that's what we use here, but you could go ahead and use the Amul cream, the blue packet Amul cream, that works fine as well. Okay, once you have all these ingredients, you could just give it a mix. Of course, you'll see some small specks. So I'm going to switch to a whisk. And just quickly give these a mix. So you'll see it gets a natural yellow color.
What's the alternative of coconut milk?
Like I said earlier, so evaporated milk, condensed milk and whole milk are your traditional, whole milk or heavy cream are your traditional ingredients. I'll tell you a little more about those ingredients when I come to making the sauce.
And Shubhangi asks, which brand of condensed milk to use?
Nestle. It's thicker, it's much better. The Amul Mithai Milk is slightly thinner, so I would recommend Nestle over here. Alright, so once you get a nice smooth texture, you can leave it at that, and now we're going to combine the dry ingredients. So, what I'm going to do is sieve these ingredients. So I have the flour. So I've already sieved this. The reason I'm sieving it again is because I'm going to be combining all the ingredients together, and I'd rather have it sieved and then mixed. Okay, so I have the flour, baking soda, baking powder, and the cinnamon powder. Again, the cinnamon powder is optional. So if you feel like you don't like cinnamon, you can always keep this in the recipe. I'm going to use a whisk and just whisk all these ingredients together. Very, very, very important step. Do not skip this, otherwise you'll get lumps of baking soda or baking powder in the cake batter. Okay, once I've done this, what I'm going to do now is combine the dry ingredients into the liquid batter. And I'm going to do this with a balloon whisk or a broader whisk so that it doesn't get stuck too much. Okay? And I'm not going to add all at once. I'm going to add this a little at a time. So you can roughly add this in three parts. So it mixes and dissolves easily. You don't want to overmix the batter. You can also opt to use some mango extract or mango essence if you feel like you want a stronger flavor of mango in your sponge. Okay, so that's also an option. You can also do this with a hand mixer, but do not mix for too long. Okay, you can see the moment they combine, I'm stopping the mixing, because what can happen is that the flour can get can develop a little gluten and your sponge may not be as moist. Okay, so quickly mixing this in, and then the last batch. So you'll see up till now it will be a slightly stiff batter, but don't worry about it because we're yet to add in the melted butter. Okay, just continue to mix. What's also important is that all your ingredients are at room temperature, okay? So we'll quickly let you see the ingredients of the sponge once again, so you're familiar with what all that I've used. Dry ingredients went in one bowl and all the wet ingredients went into the other bowl, and then we combined both of these together in parts. Okay, very important. All right, so Very quickly, coming back to the batter. Like I said, don't worry about this. You just want to ensure it's all combined. I have the melted butter here, but this is half melted just to show you. I'm going to warm this up in the microwave, and I want the butter to be warm but not hot. Okay, so anywhere between 35 and 40 degrees is good. That way it gets mixed with the batter really well. So I'm just going to warm this up.
Why do we add melted butter at the end?
So the melted butter is going to give the sponge a really nice soft texture. Okay, otherwise if you see the ingredients, it's going to give me a nice sponge, but the melted butter is going to keep it moist.
And any specific reason of eggs not being used in the recipe?
So like I said, today we're adapting and we're doing an eggless version because it's a popular choice for our viewers. But traditionally, like I said at the start, it is always made with eggs. And I would recommend if you ever want to make a tres leche recipe, you would always just go ahead with the egg-based recipe. This is an alternate version that we're doing today.
And can we use the same quantity of oil instead of butter?
I wouldn't recommend it. You could use ghee or butter. Stick to the butter. It gives you a softer, a better texture. Oil is going to make it too soft. So this sponge is going to rest in the fridge later when I have to soak it. And when it rests in the fridge, the melted butter in the recipe is actually going to help the sponge firm up. Okay? If I have oil, it's going to remain moist throughout and it will become too crumbly when I put in the soaking mixture. So butter is essential. Okay. So just going to quickly pour all the melted butter in here.
And is this unsalted butter?
Absolutely. Whenever we bake, we prefer just using unsalted butter. If you only have salted, don't worry about it. You could go ahead and use. There's no salt in this recipe, in this sponge otherwise, so don't worry about it.
Why is the melted butter not added with the wet ingredients?
Because we want it to combine really well. So if I add it in the start, it's going to leave a sort of split texture. So it's better. Now what happens, so if you can see the texture right now, it's slightly firm, like I can show you. What the melted butter does, I'm just going to quickly mix this, is that it keeps my batter really soft towards the end of it and makes it nice and smooth. Okay, that's what I'm looking for when I'm making this batter. So if I add it in the start, it's going to combine with the curds and not give me the same texture that I want.
Any alternate fruit to mango?
So in the recipe, again, I've adapted this to a mango sponge. You could go ahead and use a similar technique where I've reduced the pulp, okay? But if you don't want to add any fruit flavor to the sponge, you're just going to omit the mango pulp in the recipe, and you're going to add that much amount of milk. So if my recipe, like I showed you, calls for 60 grams 120 grams of milk. What I've done is I've taken 60 grams of pulp, 60 grams of milk. If you do not want to add any fruit flavor and keep it just a nice plain flavored sponge with vanilla, go ahead and remove that 60 grams of mango pulp, add 60 more grams of milk, and that's how you continue the recipe. Any other fruit could be added, or like I said, you could just go ahead and add an extract. Okay, so don't overmix this batter. It is slightly stiff. Also, I'm doing a slightly smaller quantity. But otherwise, this is how your batter will look. You'll see the color slightly pale and a little cinnamon, specks of cinnamon in it.
And how does the recipe vary when we use eggs?
Okay, so when you use a recipe with eggs, it's just whipped up eggs, okay? So eggs are whipped up, you get a nice fluffy texture. There are lots of variations to this. It's either egg yolks, separated, egg white separated, whipped up separately, combined. Or it's whole eggs that are whipped up and then you fold in flour and a little milk and you get a nice aerated sponge. So that's how it works with eggs. Okay, so I'm gonna quickly put this into a piping bag. Don't go to overmix this batter, I'm repeating, otherwise there are chances that you may form a little gluten in the batter.
How is the mango tres leches different from a mango gato?
So, a mango gato is essentially a cake that has layers of sponge. You can alternate this with layers of cream filled with fruit, etc. A tres leches is a sponge that is then soaked with three kinds of milk. So that's where the whole name of the dessert comes from. Alright, very quickly. So I'm using a silicone mold today. I've lightly greased this, even though it's a silicone mold, it's just easier to demold. You could use a silicone mold or you could use your baking tin. Anything, you could use anything that you have at home. If you're using a baking tin, just make sure that you either line it with parchment or that you apply a little melted butter, dust it with some flour and then fill in your batter, okay? Also, you would be required to preheat your oven to about 160 degrees. See what works best for you. I have a convection-based oven and for me, between 150 and 160 degree worked, but 160 degrees should be okay, all right? So this batter will rise quite a bit, okay? So you don't want, you don't want to fill too much in the mold. It's going to rise double in size. So make sure that you get a nice, you fill only about half and then, or a little more than half, and then it will rise to size. It depends on the height that you want. Since this is an eggless recipe, it can be a little dense, okay, because it has cream, it has a lot of liquid ingredients. I wouldn't recommend making it too tall, okay? So don't worry if the batter is a little stiff. Once it goes to the oven, it's going to melt and spread out evenly, okay? Okay, so this is going to go for baking, okay? I'm going to put this into the oven at, like I said, my oven worked great at 150 degrees. And it's going to take anywhere between 15 minutes to, if you're using a bigger mold, it can easily take you about 25 to 30 minutes. Okay? It will rise. It will give you a slight dome because it's got two leavening agents. But don't worry about it. Even if it gets a slight dome, you can always take it out. You can either cut it or by the time you soak, it'll sort of level by itself. Okay, so put this in for baking. To check that it's done, insert a skewer and that's how you can check. Important, once it comes out of baking, you want to keep the soaking sauce ready. Okay, so we're going to move on to how to make the sauce. Just make sure not to overmix, that's all. That's the only key to this recipe. Do not overmix and add in your dry ingredients a little at a time.
Bake at what temperature?
160 degrees for about 15 minutes is what my small sponge took. If you're doing a bigger one, it could take anywhere between 25 to 30 minutes. Do not go for a very high temperature. Bake it nice and slow so it's a softer, doesn't form too much of a crust. Okay? Alright, coming to the sauce. So like I showed you the ingredients earlier, what I had was milk, coconut milk, condensed milk. Okay? I'm going to combine these three ingredients. It's pretty simple. Combine. Okay, the condensed milk, like you can see, it's all of these have been at room temperature. So what I'm going to do first is slightly warm this up, okay?
And Shep, did we add sugar
into
the earlier mixture?
Just give me a moment. Sorry, yes. Did we add?
Sugar.
Yeah, the sugar was added along with the flour. So I mixed everything together and then I added it. So you can see the condensed milk over here. Okay, so the milk and the milk and coconut milk are mixed and kept over here. Condensed milk, I'm just going to directly mix it into this. I don't want to warm it up, okay? It can become too fluid otherwise, so just...
And can we use cream instead of coconut milk?
Yeah, absolutely. So the original sauce recipe the mixture calls for heavy cream, evaporated milk, condensed milk, or instead of heavy cream, you could use just milk. Okay, coming to evaporated milk, which is traditionally used, you don't get it very, very easily, but it's very easy to make. You just need to reduce milk in a saucepan by about 60% of its weight, okay? So I could start with about 4.5 cups of milk and reduce it down to about 2 cups. And that way I know that I've reduced this milk while constantly stirring. Okay, very important. It takes a very long time to make evaporated milk, but it's absolutely doable at home. Okay, so you can see the sauce is ready over here. So what I'm going to do, I've already baked this sponge and kept it ready. So just to show you, these were the sponges, the same sponge that I showed you earlier. You can see one is a little lesser height, the other one is a little taller. I've baked both sizes. One I filled just about less than half in the mold, the other one I filled about 3/4. So depending on the height that you want, okay, now there are two things. If this cake you can also layer if you wish to. Traditionally, it's just one layer of sponge and then you soak it. So if you wish to make a layer out of it, you'd soak it a little lesser and then you'd make thinner sponges so you can layer it like a cake. I'm just going to stick to doing one sponge and then soaking it. So what I've done, now important, whatever mold you bake in, all right, once it bakes and you take it out of the oven, you need to wait for it to cool down just slightly. You don't want it to become very cool. There are several ways of doing this. What I find works best is allow the sponge to still remain a little warm, not hot, but a little warm, and then you can pour this slightly warm sauce over it. So it's going to pull in nicely, and you know it absorbs really well. And then we're going to store it in the chiller, in the fridge, okay, for a couple of hours. So just to show you what I've done, you saw I baked in the silicone mold. I've just taken another pan that's slightly bigger than this, which gives me the space to put milk, okay? So, what you can do if you do not have another pan, you could just take, you could take another cake ring that's slightly bigger, place your sponge inside that and pour the soaking sauce from the top, okay? And allow it to really absorb. Now, in order for it to absorb really well, you need to poke holes in the sponge, okay? So, you can see here, I've already done that, okay? Just, I did that a little earlier. I've poked holes. This way, it absorbs the sauce really well and gives you a nice moist sponge, okay? I'm gonna do the same over here. Poke it really nicely.
And why did we heat the milk earlier?
So that it's a slightly thinner mixture and it's easier for the sponge to absorb. Even though my sponge is not super hot, it's slightly warm, right? So if my mixture is the coconut milk and milk mixture slightly warm, and I add the condensed milk mixture. It sort of gives it a good consistency for the cake to absorb. If it's very cold, it's just going to float like a layer on top. So this is how I would prefer doing it. Okay, if you wish to, you could also make a few holes in the side so it absorbs.
Can we use Amul cream instead of coconut milk?
Yes, you could, absolutely. Okay, so just to show you, what I've done is I've also lined a parchment paper here. Just so I can peel it off and it doesn't stick to my pan. Okay, now the best way to serve this is to serve it in the dish itself. Okay, because when you pour all that syrup, you're going to have some syrup that's remaining at the bottom, and it's best to scoop it out of the dish. But you could also take it out of this dish and then serve it as a separate piece. I'm going to show you how to plate it today. That's one way I'm going to show you. But like I said, it's best served in the dish that you pour the sauce. Okay? So very quickly, I have the sauce over here. And you have two ways to do this. I could either take the cake, dunk it, okay, and then lift it and place it over there. But since this is a small piece, I'm not going to get as much grip and it can crumble. So I've poked sufficient holes. So I'm just going to soak. So you can see I've poked those holes and they're taking in the sponge really well. It's going into the sponge, absorbing it. Okay, do not hesitate to pour as much as you want to. Okay. So you could say for a size like this, I would roughly pour about 50 to 60 grams of this mixture in total. Okay, it could nicely take about that much. I'm going to soak it in the sides.
We can use almond milk instead of coconut.
Possible, yes, you could. I'm using coconut milk for the flavor because it complements the mangoes. Okay, what you can also do is, once you've done this much, you could go ahead, poke a few more holes. Okay, once the first absorption is done, then you can go ahead and pour a little more syrup into this, so you know it's thoroughly absorbed.
Can we use coconut sugar instead of caster sugar?
Absolutely, yes, you could. So, soaking the other one just to show you, okay? So you have to remember, when you do a recipe without egg, that is a recipe with egg, that is the classical way of doing this, it's going to be a different color, okay? It's also going to be a much whiter sponge inside, because you're not adding any, you're not adding any cinnamon, you're not adding anything that can brown as much. You get a nice whiter sponge inside. All right, so once this goes, what you're going to do now is you're going to allow this to rest in the fridge for a couple of hours, or you can let this rest overnight depending on when you want to serve it. Just remember, you want it to be nice and absorbed. Okay, you would place it inside another pan and cling wrap it or keep it airtight so it doesn't become too dry. All right,
is it the first extract of coconut milk or the second?
So I'm using the one that we get in the packet. You could, the first one is going to be too thick. I suggest use the second one. It needs to be slightly fluid. Okay, use the second, should be good. You want that flavor. If it's too watery, again, it's going to thin down your sauce too much. So go ahead. I've just used the one that, the Dabur and coconut milk.
Does the coconut sugar harden the sponge?
No, it should be okay.
And in case you're selling it in a patisserie, what's the best way to store it?
To store, so you could use, store this in the fridge. It's not going to spoil very easily. Store it for up to a week, no problem. But the longer it stays, it's going to become more dry. So store it in an airtight. If you want, you can store them in boxes with lids. I don't know if you know, there's a famous bakery called Magnolia Bakery. So they also sell these. They sell it in a nice box with a lid, and it can be stored for some time. If not, freeze the sponge, soak it the night before, and then sell it fresh for a day. Usually these items are good for a day or two, not more than that, once they're soaked. Okay, so I'm going to quickly just, I prepared some already, and I'm going to show you how you can now plate this dessert. So just give me 1 second. Okay, so I soaked these, kept these in the chiller for a couple of hours, and you can see they're nice, moist, okay? The parchment is there below, and I'm going to demold. So these were baked, soaked for a couple of hours, and now I'm going to show you how you can finish this dessert, okay? Okay, so I'm going to show you 2 ways in which you can do this dessert. One, I'm going to plate it today because I'm a huge fan of plated desserts, and I feel like they will add some, it looks really pretty. So I've got 2 plates over here, 2 variations. I'm going to show you one inside a dish like this, and I'm going to show you one on a flat plate, okay? So, just to lift this out, you could just lift the parchment, okay, and this is a little moist at the bottom, okay. So what I'm going to do is hold this on the side, and you'll see that what I did was I put a little sauce at the bottom as well, so it's a little moist but nicely soaked even at the bottom, okay. So I'm going to place this on this plate. Okay, for the other plate, very quickly, I'm just going to show you what I'm going to do. So the same soaking sauce that I used, which is coconut milk, evaporated condensed milk and regular milk, I have some mango pulp over here. So I'm going to mix some of this mango pulp into this. So it gives me some mango sauce at the bottom, okay? So just going to mix this. You'll see I get a nice mango color, yellow color, sorry. Okay, so you can see beautiful yellow color to complement your mango dessert. Okay, just gonna add in a little more to give me a little more strength. Again, you can, these are optional things, okay? If you wish to not have so much mango, it's absolutely fine. I just felt like it added a nice complementing flavor along with my cake. Okay, so nice and thick, yellow in color. What I'm going to do is in this plate, I'm just going to spoon a bit of this mixture at the bottom.
Is this fresh mango pulp?
Yes, this is fresh mango pulp. Okay, so I'm just going to leave this over here.
And can we use mango crush instead of mango pulp?
It's not going to give you the same flavor. It's going to be too sweet and it gives you that artificial flavor. So please, since we're doing this only because it's mango season. You have fresh mangoes. If you cannot access fresh mangoes, you also have the option of using frozen mango puree. Okay, which are readily available again with Diva Ravi fruit. Use that because those are the fresh fruit that have been pureed and frozen immediately. I would suggest, recommend not using mango crush.
Chef, can we use wheat flour instead of refined flour?
I wouldn't recommend it. Again, it's going to make your batter too dense. So I would not suggest using wheat flour in this recipe. Okay. All right. So I have the other piece. What I'm going to do is just carefully slide this down to the center. Okay, so it's sitting in the center of my bowl. Okay, so you can see I have that lovely yellow color. And now what I've kept ready on the side is some whipping cream. Okay, I have some dairy whipping cream. If you do not have dairy whipping cream, you could go ahead and use feel free to use your non-dairy cream. Okay, both work fine. So I whip this till a slight stiff peak. Okay,
how many grams of essence can we add in the sponge?
How many grams of?
Essence.
So I've mentioned it in the recipe. I've added, you can add up to 10 grams of vanilla essence. Okay, so for this I have a Sultana nozzle. It's a really beautiful nozzle. What it's going to do is give me a nice, beautiful texture on top. So this is just, like I said, whipping cream. I've prepared a mango coriander mixture. Okay, all you have to do is take a little bit of butter, melt it in the saucepan, and put in your mangoes, just a little bit, and put in the coriander, chopped coriander, and just give it a mix. You don't want it to overcook. Coriander and mango pair beautifully, gives you a lovely, lovely flavor, and it goes absolutely beautifully with your cream. Okay, so I'm just going to top this. So the green, the mangoes, they look beautiful along with this dessert. Just going to top it with some mint. Okay, and I also have some mango that I can put at the bottom. Okay, so that's, like I said, that's one way to plate this dessert. All right, the other way that I'm going to plate this dessert, so the same mango sauce, I'm going to put it into a piping bag. All right, and this, I'm going to be doing a very freestyle, casual, rustic way of plating this dessert. Something that you just look at and say, I want to eat this right now. So, okay, just going to do a drizzle of the sauce on my plate. With the whipping cream, alright, so take the same whipping cream, you can spread it on top, just like a nice dollop, spread it on top. So this dairy cream is not very sweet, which is why you can see I'm putting a nice amount, because it cuts through that sweet flavor that is absorbed inside the sponge, okay? So this whipped cream gives it a very light flavor when you eat the dessert. I'm going to finish with the same mango. Okay, so just chunks of mango here and there. This is the mango coriander salsa. Right, just drop a few pieces here, there. Alright, so if anyone has any questions, you can ask me. And what I also have are some pistachio nibs, okay? So pista goes well again with mango. And I'll finish with a sprig of mint. Okay, so that's your dessert. So I hope you enjoyed watching us make this. I hope you try it out and get back to us with photos of the same dessert that you've made. And we'd love to see your creations. You can tag us on APCA India, or you could also send across your photos to me. I'm known as Chef Michelle Paris on Instagram. If you have any queries, I'd love to answer them. But I thoroughly hope you enjoyed today's session. And our version of the mangoes, Sri Leche. So we're also going to be uploading these videos on YouTube and IGTV. It'll happen maybe by tomorrow at the latest, but you can always go back and look at the recipe and the way that we've made it. But I really hope you've enjoyed the session. Thank you.